Next, let's take a look at some corresponding product models and the modules of this card. So here we will introduce a specific one separately, because actually these two things are quite similar. For example, let's introduce the S2700. We understand the positioning of the S2700. It is a gigabit access switch, right? 100 megabit access switch. Now let's take a look at the overall appearance of this S2700. In terms of the overall appearance, let's take a closer look one by one. What does this section represent? Indicating that it is a 24-port Ethernet electrical interface. In simple terms, it is an electrical port. Generally, this is used as a downlink. It is a downlink, then it's 100 megabytes. The second part is a gigabit Ethernet interface. You can say this is an uplink. The third part is a combo interface. What is a combo interface? It has both an electrical port and an optical port. So these two ports, generally speaking, they both end up with one mouth. It means these two interfaces. You can only use one. Either plug in this network cable. Either plug this fiber optic cable into this port, but you can't use both ports at the same time. Do not use simultaneously. If it is inserted at the same time, mainly based on this port, mainly based on electrical ports, if they are separated, who plugs in first and where? Who takes effect first, then the other may not take effect. Such a form. Then the fourth port, that means we are on a switch. It's a rather important interface, used for management. It is a console port, after our equipment is purchased, after the equipment procurement. Our first operation, it's to be done through this console cable, connect the computer to this switch, perform a basic configuration, provisioning, and then later we can use this network as a form, visit it network access form. So this is an exterior view of S2700 appearance. So moving on to this section, it's a screw for grounding, used to connect this grounding wire. The one behind is one of these sockets used to plug in this power supply, plugged in. So here, a detailed product specification for an S2700. Everyone can take a look at what is supported. For example, him. Actually, only support this. He supports some simple routing protocols. For example, static routing and RAP. So we have more of protocols like OSPF and BGP. Our S2700 does not support this. S2700 is not supported. So this is our S2700. Then some other performance specifications. Let's take a brief look. The downstream port rate is also good. The speed of the upstream port is also good. Just introduced. Introduction completed. So in this case, it's one of our S2700. So next, let's introduce another model, the S5700. Regarding S5700, what he said is one, this is a product that we are currently promoting more. Featured products. So in terms of his product, divided into four series, so you can see it also says below. Divided into this simplified version, Li series, this L, it's light, lightweight and streamlined standard, then enhanced and advanced. So this standard, HCIA Data Center Network S, is the standard for standard EI is hardcore enhanced. And this high, it's the advanced version of high performance. It is divided into LI, SI, EI, HI, four versions. So these four versions will also be introduced later. What are the differences between them? What differences are there between the two each time? So this are a complete set of S-box switches. In fact, this height of his, all are 1U. All are 1U. If it's 1U equals to 44.45 millimeters, 44.45 millimeters, such a height. Now, let's take a look at what's coming next, the appearance of this S5720. Product appearance. So what about the appearance of this product? Actually, it's related to the S2700 we just mentioned. Just to introduce, there is actually no significant difference. No significant difference. So the one on our left in this part, it is still a 48-port downstream one. 1 gigabit interface. So it is used for downstream. So this second part, that's what we have here. 410 GE optical port. So this we can use it as an uplink. So the third part, it is an Ethernet management port. So regarding this port, we usually connect to the management network, general connection to management network. So this is the fourth port. It is a mini USB port. So this mini USB port, actually, it's related to this fifth part, this console port. Actually, something similar. It's just that the interface form is different. Its purpose all are processed through. Similar to a console form, configure its initialization, initial configuration. So this is the sixth part. It's one of our mini USBs. Part six, it is a USB port. So this USB port, mainly used for this, applied to the beginning of this USB flash drive. You can save this configuration file. Put it into this USB flash drive. This form serves as a reminder to start from 7 to 12. In this section, let's just go over it briefly. So in this case, power supply supports two slots. And then regarding this plug-in card, supports two slots as well. So regarding this slot, it can support this SIM card. You can expand on this card, the number of ports or the number of ports, such a form. So this is our S5720, one of HI's appearance. So this S5720, it is the industry's first, an agile switch. It adopts this fully programmable architecture. So it has this software defined capability. It is programmable. So what else does it provide? Provide this rich agile features. We refer to this as an agile switch, H switch. What functions does it have? Typical, it has the functionality of this IC. This is the wireless IC, such a function as access controller. So it has achieved this switch, supports both wired functions. Also supports wireless functionality, deep fusion integration. What else is supported? Also support this with business and network convergence as the core. It has the ability to accompany this business on the go capability. What else is supported? Also supports this type of IPCA. IPCA is this to determine the quality of service of our network. Business quality. What else is supported? Also supports an advanced feature of this SVF. Later, SVF will also be introduced. It is a vertical virtualization. So this is an S5720. It is a rather special switch. Next, let's take a look at the product specifications of this S5720. Product specifications. That is in the product specifications. We will briefly introduce this S5720, a slight difference. Build in this Ethernet processing processor chip, EMP chip, so the customer. No need to replace this new hardware within 6 months, about to go live quickly. Quickly launched, then it has built-in functionality. Also support the functions of this AC, just emphasized, it can enable a switch to support network management, manage this wired manage wireless. So next, let's take a look at these four versions. What is the typical difference between LISI, EI, and HI that was just mentioned? They must have functional differences. So that's why there is such a division. So on this 5700, we can look at it this way. We implement this feature divided into these three categories. For example, this RIP. For example, like this OSPF, BGP ping multicast. Wait for these things and support this type of 2.5 layer just now. That can be understood as this three layer. So this is on the second and a half floor. For example, this MPLS second point, 5 floor. Other advanced features, net stream operations, administration, and maintenance bidirectional forwarding detection, BFD. So let's take a look at this HCIA data center network. LI, we see LI all are unsupported, and this S5700. It supports this first one. It supports this 5700 SI support. This RIP enterprise interface support, this one, and also support this three layer one. For example, this OSPF BGP weight and this high all series are supported. So this HCIA data center network, it's this advanced type. That is the one with the highest performance, this switch. Next, let's take another look at this S6700. It is a 10 gigabit box switch. So this 10 gigabit box switch. Let's take a brief look at its appearance. In fact, this appearance, as mentioned before, there is no significant difference. Just saying there will be some differences in its interface speed. For example, you have this uplink for 2. You can see this is the second port. This is the uplink. This is a 40G EQSFP module, an optical interface for an Ethernet network. You will find this 40GE interface with this 10GE interface. There is a clear distinction. Now this will be wider. Not like that. This is a standard type of power socket. This is a 40GE interface. So moving on, let's take a look at the product specifications. Product specifications. So for this S6720, it supports this single unit. 48 of 110 gigabit. And this is a 40GE port with full line speed forwarding for these 6. So it also supports this long distance stacking. Long distance stacked bi-directional stacking, bandwidth can achieve this 480 gigabytes and also supports this kind of DOS attack prevention. Wait for some functions. What else is supported? It also supports some QoS features MPLS. Some of the processing functions of MPLS. Then he also supports this 1+1 redundant backup. He also supports this mixing of AYMOC and DC power supplies. Mixing of IC and DC electricity. So, with our product, this introduction. That's all for the introduction. Next, let's take a look at what? Let's take a look at the numbering rule for this interface. Interface numbering rules. So, this interface numbering rule, a slight difference. What's the difference? It's the situation where we have this stacking or mismatch. So let's take a look. In terms of quantity, when we look at it, his identification number. All based on this three-digit number. For example, it is XYZ. These three are done by this serial number. If there is no stacking, without stacking his first, similar to this slot number. Actually, this slot number. Not very significant. He can be set to 0, can be set as 1. In this case, you can actually modify. So the only difference after our stacking. After stacking, we'll assign this slot number, become a member of this stack. We know that if a device, no matter what the slot number is, we also know that this switch is just a bunch of ports. So if it is stacked, after stacking, we will change this slot number to a stack number. The purpose of stacking is to combine several physical switches. Become a logical switch. You are similar to the original. How many box switches are there? Now it becomes a modular switch. So, since it has become a modular switch, how do we differentiate whether it is you or the first slot of the switch? Slot of the second switch. Therefore, we will take care of this. During stacking, we'll go to set up this member stack. Stack this member number. So if your stack number is 1, that's 101. For example, this port number. If you are the second switch, it is 201. In this case, let's distinguish on which switch to configure this port number. Configure the switch port number. So what are the rules for interface? Numbering. From this diagram, we can see it is stacked from bottom to top. Go in this order. Name this rule. So everyone must pay attention to this and take a look. Port number of this switch. So about the power module. That's how it is. Regarding our S2700, it is built in with a single power supply for power supply. It does not support this hot swappable type power module. As for our S5700, it supports hot swapping, supports hot swap, and it does not support this kind of communication. It's also this kind of electricity, this branch, and it supports this kind of PoE, this power module of power over Ethernet power module. So the S6700 is the same. It also supports hot swapping. Of course, pay attention to what? If you want to replace this power module, be sure to ensure the other power module of these two power modules of yours, it must be in a powered state. Otherwise, your service will be interrupted. We call it hot swap. You also need to ensure that this does not interrupt. Non-disruptive service. Okay, so regarding this PoE, we are going to talk about what PoE means. We see in the naming of that interface just now. In the naming of this port, of this interface, in this entire product. Is there a PW2? So this PW2, what does it mean to just sell a riddle? PW2, that is to say it supports this PoE function. The power supply labeled as P will have the wording PW2 on it. For example, S5710-52C, PW2EI the version, number for EI. So the front one is this PW2. Just like this supports PoE power supply powered by PoE. Where is PoE power supply generally used? You're such a PoE. For example, I am doing this for wireless AP or, to put it another way, this camera supports this form of direct power supply via Ethernet. Ethernet, power supply form. So a PoE powered switch like this. How many interfaces can it support for power supply? This actually goes with this. Some corresponding standards, there will be some differences. There will be differences. So in this table, actually listed out, it is theoretically the maximum number of interfaces. Theoretical maximum number of interfaces. So the specific model, you can also refer to the hardware description in the product documentation. Hardware description. So we still have support. We know our S5720 support this. Is it the one to insert the card? Then we can see which ones are supported. For example, the entire S2700 series does not support it. Regarding the S5700, besides this, the ones written here. For example, S5700LI, 5700SLI, etc. These words not supported externally. Other models are supported. All are supported. So for this S6720EI, supported S6720EI is supported. So how do we know if he can actually support plug-in cards? It's actually very simple. Just say that my model comes with a C inside. That means he is a supporter of plug-in cards. For example, S5700-28C-EEI. So he is someone who supports this SIM card insertion, supports hot swappable. So this is our S series insert card status. Now, let's take a brief look at the inventory of this S series plug-in card. We can see some support front insert card. This is the card slot at the back regarding S270. All are not supported. Regarding S570 are part of, it's a front insert card. Part of it is hot swappable. Regarding S670, only this EI version. The EI version of 6720 supports this rear insert card. Each one's words, you can see each of these plug-in cards. Actually, one aspect of this is that the speeds are different. On the one hand, the number of ports is different. Currently, the number of ports and their speeds on this interface may also vary. Wait, so this is based on the specific situation. Let's select the corresponding expansion card for this.